Hey guys, welcome back. And for those who are wondering what's on my lips, this is Estee Lauder Pure Envy Lipstick in Restless, I believe is what it's called. It's the one that was signed by Kendall Jenner. I just thought you might be interested to know what this really bright lipstick is. And it's my way of making me look a little bit more perky, even though I'm quite sick and you can probably tell. And since I look the same as the last video, then you can probably tell that these are pre-filmed videos. Anyway, I wanted to come on here and show you my UK haul. Now, there's going to be a little bit of pretty much everything. Clothes, makeup, and some planner related items. So I'm going to start off with fashion, and I'm going to be inserting some like try on clips on the side just so you can see what it actually looks like on. And this one set I'm going to show you first is bought with a voucher that Duncan's brother and his sister-in-law gave me for Christmas. And I was eyeing this, and if you've watched if you were watching my travel vlog, you would have seen me feature this while I was doing window shopping in Primark. I love Primark. I do. Anyway, this one here. This is a gorgeous trench coat. Let me go ahead and back up a little bit. It's a gorgeous trench coat, and the detailing on here, would you believe this is only £25? So that's what? Well, maybe $35? $30, yeah. So look at that. And at the back, you got that little flap here. It comes with its own belt that goes around. It's got like belt loops, and you can put the belt inside. The material of this one is really, really nice. And look at that hook on the belt. It's beautiful. Even the buttons, like look at how cool those buttons are. And when you lift the collar, can see that it's got some leather lining on there, and really the detail. This is something that other shops would probably sell for £60, but this was only £25 at Primark, and this is from their Atmosphere line, and I'm in a size 10. Yeah, I wore this in London quite a lot. I also did get some basics. You'll probably find this funny, but this is a two-hook bra extension or extenders. So yeah, just in case, you know, because I gain weight and I lose weight, like my weight fluctuates, and sometimes my bras feel a little bit too tight around the rib area, and I can see them digging into my skin. Can feel them digging into my skin, so I thought I'd grab one of these. There's like 1, 2, 3 of those bra extenders inside, but obviously they're still intact because I haven't had to use them yet. Other two basics, that was £2 by the way for a set of three. The other basics that I got are camisoles. Okay, so this one here, oh, it's got a bit of a stain. I'm sure that's something that will come out when I wash it. And it's something that I would wear underneath something anyway. So it comes in white and in black. Again, size 10. So yeah, this too is probably going to throw off the white balance out of my camera. So those two. And then, so there were £3 each. So we are now at £8 plus 25 is 33. Okay. And then I got four tops for £5 each. Okay, so here are the four £5 tops. This one here, it's a beautiful striped shirt, long sleeve. It doesn't have like the normal cuff. It's a loose cuff. And it's elasticated at the bottom, and I really like how this falls on the body. It's got very soft material. It's got that beautiful like neckline with a pocket, and it's just gorgeous. I love it. When I first saw it, I was like, I need to get that. Okay, then this one I wore for that Christmas dinner, and it is gorgeous. It's a beautiful red V-neck with a bow in the front. Let me just go ahead and tie the bow so you can see. And the bow has got some metallic detail that just makes it look so festive. See? So there you go. You got your bow there, and it's got this metal detail, gold metal detail, and a side slit. You can really move with this one. I really like that. And it's a very, very festive. And I got these things because I was thinking that these are some things that I could actually even potentially wear when I go back into the corporate world. So, very practical choice. Now, this one here, I really like this when I got this. They're all size 10, by the way. But this one shrunk in the wash and now is too tight for me. But I'm hoping this is going to be my someday shirt. I'm hoping that I'm going to lose a little bit of weight in my midsection and will be able to wear this again because the material is so nice. The stripe is so flattering. And I do love the neckline here that I really want to be able to wear this again. And I wear this with the sleeves rolled up. So there you go. That's one. And the last 5 pounder is this beautiful one here. It's a geometric one. And I just really like it. There you go. And it's got a zip at the back. It's gorgeous, isn't it? Now, there were a few other things that I bought in Primark, but not with the gift voucher that I received. So I'm going to show that to you guys as well. Right now, you'll be seeing a video or a video clip of me wearing pajamas. These are like flannel inspired maroon and white pajamas. And they're very, very comfortable. I bought pajamas because my pajama that was gifted to me by Duncan 4 years ago, got a tear in the bum and tear got bigger and bigger. I tried to sew it together. It just came apart and unraveled. So I had to get a new one. This is one pair. And I also got another pair that fits exactly the same, has the same texture, but has got this design. It's white with some blue and red and pink hearts. There you go. The pajama sets were $8. Yes, top and bottom together. £8, not dollars, £8. Okay, then I saw this top and I was just like, wow, I want that. It came in a few different colors, but this color called on to me. It's very pastel. It's got some lilac and peach on it. And it's like a wrap over, and you can actually see through that. Okay, it's a wrap over, but at the back, you actually have a long bottom at the back. There you go. And this was £10. It's a bit more expensive than the other 5 pounders, but hey. Oh, and if you're ever in London and you attempt to go into the Primark on Oxford Street, oh my God, that one is massive. And not only is it massive, it's filled with people. I mean, I guess because it was the Christmas season that it would definitely be filled with people, but oh my God. And then the last thing that I got is this pair of trousers. Now, I thought this would be great for work, and this was only £9. £9. It's got pockets on the side. It's got that beautiful lining on the waist area. So I got this and said to myself, I'm eventually going to be using that when I go back into the corporate world anyway. So go ahead, £9. You can't go wrong with that. So that is all the fashion bits that I got at Primark, but I did also get a few accessories. One of them is this one. This is beautiful. For £1, I got a pair of, well, two pairs of tweezers. One's got the pointed one, and one's got the slanted tip. And for £1, and how pretty is that rose gold color? Another thing that I got from Primark from their cosmetic section is their 4-pack blender sponge. Yeah, blenders. Now, this one, feels like a stress ball to me. I'm probably not going to use that at all. And I've tried wetting this particular one, the pink one, doesn't expand at all. However, the orange ones and this lime yellow one, this one expands. I've tried that. This one expands, and I'll show you because this other one is wet. So that's how big it expands to when you wet this one. These are really, really soft. I mean, holding on to them, even when they're, this is a Real Techniques sponge. They are softer than Real Techniques, but not as soft as, where's my beauty blender? Not as soft as a beauty blender, but very close, actually. Now that I'm pressing them together, they feel very close to each other. Although the beauty blender looks a bit more porous, this one's a bit smoother. Don't know if you can actually tell. Maybe you can. But yeah, the softness is very close. It's in between the softness of the beauty blender and the Real Techniques sponges. So I really adore that. And for 1 pound, 2 pound 50 for four, I mean, even if I don't use this, right, I could use it for probably like nail art or something. Like, imagine this is 1 pound, 1 pound, and 50 pence. That's totally worth it. Because how much is a beauty blender? It's $20, right? So anyway, I got those. And then I was really intrigued by, well, I took it out of the packaging already because I've been using it. It came in this kind of packaging. And this is that. Okay, now if you guys, you probably have seen this all over YouTube, the makeup eraser thing. So this one has got microfiber in the front, and on the other side, on the flip side, is more of the fluffy kind of material. And it's supposed to be good for removing makeup. You just wet it with water and you use it on your face to remove your makeup. Now, from my experience, it's only good for removing your powder makeup, like your blush, your eyeshadow. If you use it with your lipstick, it's gonna drag. And if you use it on foundation, it's gonna drag. And it doesn't take away everything. I have a regular microfiber cloth that does a better job than this one. So if you want my opinion on this, if it's worth, how much was this? £1.50. If it's worth £1.50, just go to Poundland or your dollar store and get yourself a microfiber cloth. You could probably get three of these for the price, and works better than this one. This is cute, it's pretty, but it's not as effective as it's supposed to be. Okay, now I don't know if the makeup eraser, the actual makeup eraser that's $20, is any better than that. Now, the last things that I got from Primark are these metal matte liquid lipsticks. Let me just show you. There you go. I have swatched these. I'm going to go ahead and, let me swatch it live for you guys. And I've actually tried to wear one of them. This one is called Goddess. Okay, so let's try this. This light one that I think is going to be, or I thought was going to be great as a lipstick topper, although I haven't actually used it as a lipstick topper. Swatch just like that. It smells of cherry. It's so pretty, isn't it? This one is called Goddess. It's got gold specks, gold glitter in it. I don't know if you can see that gold glitter in it. This is the one that I wore. And I'll tell you what I think about it. And the last one is called Kylie. They actually have one that's called Kendall. That is more of a nude. Okay. And this Kylie one, when I swatched this, took forever to come off. So that is Queen, Goddess, and Kylie. Looks pretty, but they crumble off. Yes, when you put them on your lips, once they dry, it just crumbles to pieces. And see how when they dry, they leave a little bit of a stain, but It just isn't, I don't think it's worth it. They're £2 each. So a total of £6. I could have bought a top for the price of these. Actually, let me go ahead and try this one that I thought was going to be a good topper. From my experience, oh, that is gorgeous. But let's see. I'm gonna get back to you guys on how I feel about it after it dries and it starts to show the lines on my lips. Anyway, so those are the things that I got from Primark, and I also went into Superdrug because why not, right? So I went into Superdrug because I was looking for this palette that is a dupe for Kat Von D, and I found it. But I did also buy a few other things. So at Superdrug, I was looking for this, and I went through several Superdrugs to find this particular palette. And tell me, what does that look like to you guys? What does it look like? Okay, this is the Revolution Makeup Ultra Eye Contour Light and Shade Palette. Talc-free formula, by the way, it says there. And yeah, this is a dupe for the Kat Von D Shade and Light Eye Contour Palette. So I got that, and then I wanted to get something that was similar to the Naked 3 palette. I actually found two. This one didn't come from Superdrug. This one I found at B&M, which is like a wholesale store in Scotland. This is a W7 in the nude. Okay, when you open it up, it looks like that. They even tried to copy the container, but this one's pretty clunky and also quite thick, and it doesn't come with a mirror. I would have liked it better if it had a mirror, but those are the shades. So you can really see that they tried to copy the Naked 3. However, I also, this was originally £8, or I think $7.99, but it came down to $4.99 at B&M, which is, like I said, a wholesale shop. I also found some of these at TK Maxx. Now, this one is the Revolution Redemption Palette in Iconic 3, and this one is also a dupe for the Naked 3. Now, I don't have the Naked 3, but I've seen a lot of videos on YouTube comparing, swatching, wear tests, and everything. And these two come really close to that. So watch out for a review of those. This is also from Revolution Makeup, and this is what they call the Ultra Pro Glow. And when you open that up, those are the shades that you see. And I have heard a few of the UK YouTubers say that these are dupes for the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit. Like this particular one is called, I think it's a dupe for Sweets, if I'm not mistaken. The one that's got the like the pink highlight. And this one on here is a dupe for that glow, I believe. So like for one palette to have a dupe for two of their highlighters, I thought was pretty good. This, by the way, was £10. This one was £8. The Iconic palette is £4. The Indie Nude palette is $7.99, but I got it for $4.99. And then also, Superdrug had, actually, Revolution Makeup had this promo where if you purchased anything that is worth, excuse me, £10 or more, you get a Revoholic palette. Now, this Revoholic palette is a lip palette. And look at that. It's gorgeous. And I have swatched these, and they are actually very pigmented. So, do they smell? No, no scent. So I was pretty happy with those palettes. Now, I know I said that I was minimizing and decluttering and all that, but I only come to the UK once a year, and I thought I would go ahead and purchase some things that I have been eyeing so that I don't have to pay for shipping. And yeah. Now, at Boots, now, I didn't really want to buy any makeup from Boots because, well, none of them actually interested me. But Maybelline was having a 243. What? No, 342. 342 promo. So I did get some of their Superstay 7 Days Gel Nail Color. Because I've heard so many people talk about this. This one is in the color Golden Brown, and it actually comes off as rose gold on your nails. I should have worn this. I should have. I also wanted to get a matte one. So this one is called Rose Powder. So it's like a dusty rose shade. And then a top coat. This is called a Plumping Top Coat 3D Gel Effect. And they also had a promotion that if you bought 3 items from Maybelline, you get a free Maybelline Superstay 24 Makeup Locking Setting Spray. So even though this were $342, so technically I only paid $42, I also got this. So there. I haven't tried it. Obviously, it's still sealed and everything, but yeah. Is that everything that I got? I think so. I think that's all of the makeup that I got. Now, there's one item that I got from, what's it, W.H. Smith? I think it's one of the bookstores. I think it is W.H. Smith. We walked in and they had this promotion for the Paper Mate Ink Joy Pens. I have them here. It is a box of 25 pens. I only have these out right now because the rest are like duplicate colors, so I didn't really see the need to actually bring them all out. But I'll post a picture here somewhere to show you that it came in a box of 25 for £6.99. If you bought anything from the shop, anything at all, it doesn't have to have a price tag that is more than £6.99. So Duncan ended up buying a Gordon Ramsay book. I think it is a Gordon Ramsay book for £6. And I got this for £6.99 instead of £20. Was it £20? I think so. So I was pretty chuffed with that. I was pretty happy. And I got my pens. And I do love how these write. Oh, I almost forgot to get back to you guys about this lip topper that I use. This is Queen from Primark. And it's not actually so bad. The one that I tried before Goddess actually started to crumble and the glitter, maybe I put too much, but as a topper, it actually works really nicely and I really, really like it. Yeah. This one's worth buying. Go get it. Queen. So yeah, that's my UK haul for you guys. I hope that you enjoy this. I know it was pretty long. I did have a lot of things to purchase, but I really loved it.